on John McCallum's comments, I want to turn to Peter MacKay. He's, of course, a former Minister of Foreign Affairs and a former Minister of Justice under Stephen Harper's government. He's now a partner at the international law firm Baker McKenzie, and he joins us, as you can see, in studio. So, Peter, thank you for coming in.
Sure.
Let's talk about John McCallum's comments. They raised a lot of eyebrows, a lot of people caught off guard. What do you think his motivation was?
Well, Natasha, I think when you unpack his comments in the entire context, firstly, not very diplomatic, certainly surprising, some would say inappropriate to be commenting on the merits of the case. So he spoke early on about the importance of our judicial system being independent and arm's length from government decisions, but then followed on with a bit of a rambling, running commentary about the president's comments, and those alluded to as being inappropriate, the fact that this was an extraterritorial request, which is part of an extradition. And then thirdly, he referenced the fact that Canada has not signed on to international sanctions against Iran, which is at the very core of the case itself. But the comment, to quote you back to you, that raised eyebrows was to say that Ms. Bang had a strong case. And so this very much gives the impression to those who are following the case closely, and it is a complex matter, that the government somehow has taken a position, and that this perhaps isn't arm's length from government, which is the exact opposite impression that we want to give the Chinese, and we certainly don't want the Americans to think that we've already come to a conclusion about the case before it goes before a judge.
Well, let me pose to you another interpretation of his comments, that they were actually very strategic. We know that the press conference where he made those comments were for Chinese language media. He's speaking to a very specific audience, an audience that has perceived how this whole scene has unfolded in a very particular way. Was it inappropriate, or was it a brilliant political strategy?
Well, let's look at that. Does anybody think that you can speak to one specific audience in today's world?
No, I guess not.
With media, and here we are talking about it clearly, so it went well beyond speaking just to the Chinese. And should we speak about the case at a press conference to any particular audience? Diplomats, by design, by nature, act subtly, act behind the scenes, speak to ministers, speak to governments, sometimes bringing messages that could very much imperil the country's position, let alone a person's personal safety. And we have Canadians in custody in China. So this is a very, very sensitive case, to state the obvious. And I'm a bit surprised, quite frankly, that Ambassador McCallum said the things that he did today. It is a highly explosive case with much at stake, many knock-on interpretations. If he was trying to be strategic or somehow brilliant, I don't think that that's the outcome. I could be wrong, but it seems to me that this crossed the line.
You were in the House of Commons with John McCallum. You've seen how he interacts. There has been in the past times where he's spoken off the cuff. And some have been wondering today, well, is this John McCallum just being John McCallum?
It could very well be. And yes, I've had interactions with John in the past. He's a very bright man. He's very experienced. He's worked internationally. And so I was surprised. But he has to know that as ambassador, he is speaking for the Canadian government. And that is exactly how China would interpret this. And so if there were messages that he wished to bring to the Chinese government on this case, he could have done so through the normal diplomatic channels. I've dealt with Chinese ministers in the past. They have a completely different interpretation of what our system is. They don't believe that within our rule of law we have an independent judiciary. They don't believe in some of the very same protections that Ms. Meng is being afforded. She's out on bail. Her case was brought before a judge very quickly. Not so in the case of Mr. Corvig and Mr. Spanter, who are still in custody, very little access to consular services, to lawyers, or to the ability to go before a judge. And so with all of that very much in the mind of Mr. McCallum, to be commenting on the merit of the case and calling it a strong case, to me, was not very strategic and not very smart.
So if, let's say that that's the case, that he was speaking independently, that he made these comments, that they were not strategic, that they were not based on what the government's position is, how do you think the PMO is going to handle this?
Well, I think you saw the Prime Minister respond and very much reinforce the part of the message that Mr. McCallum gave, which is we have an independent judiciary, we have a rule of law, we respect the process. And so he went too far in getting into the detail and the merits. I would also be concerned, as we should be, about the Americans who are preparing to make their case before a judge, and this looks like we are taking sides. And we're in a tough spot. There's no question we're between a rock and a hard place, China and the United States, the economic implications and the sanctions, and bring Iran into this as well now, and this having a lot of, you know, very real consequences, retaliatory arrests in China. So we have to walk a very fine line, and this is not in keeping with that subtlety that I think is necessary, and just not commenting on cases before the court. Unfortunately, this seems to be a bit of a trend. We've seen this in the past, even from our own Prime Minister and Justice Minister, in a case where a jury made a decision, and before a decision was taken on appeal, whether that case would proceed, they were tweeting about it. And so,
remind us the story that you're talking about.
Well, I'm talking about the case involving the tragic death of Colton Bushi in Saskatchewan, and a jury decision which was controversial, and the Minister of Justice and the Prime Minister very quickly making commentary about that jury decision before appeals could have been contemplated, before the justice system could run its course. And by the way, coming back to the main case, don't expect this to be resolved quickly. In my opinion, there is an appeal process when it comes to these extraditions. We know the Americans are still preparing information that has to be presented before a judge.
So if you say not quickly, how long do you think this will all take?
Well, they have, I believe, a very short time now, a week or more, to present their evidence, which the ambassador was commenting on, and then the judge may very well reserve decision, and then there is an appeal process depending on what the judge decides.
Okay. We'll continue to watch, and we'll continue to turn to you for your insights. Thank you so much, Peter.